In this micro TV, we will introduce a new function from FileNet 559, skip deleting content from a source storage area. Here is the agenda. First, we will talk about the moving content behavior before FileNet 559, and the second part is the behavior from 559. Then, the third part is how to add parameter when setting skip deleting content from source storage area. The last part is the test steps for this feature. Now, this is the first part, moving content behavior before 559. We all know that moving content can be considered as a two-step process. The first is pulling content into the target storage area. The second is deleting the content from the source storage area. Before a move content is conducted, a check will be done to decide if the content can be deleted from the source storage area. And move content operation does not start if the content cannot be deleted from the source storage area at the check time. This is because in FileNet CPE, document content can only be stored in one storage area. For advanced storage area, the same content can be saved into multiple storage devices, which in the same storage area. Next, the second part, this behavior from 559. Here is the difference we need to point out. From 559, before move content is conducted, a check can be done to decide if the content can be deleted from the source storage area. The check finds the parameter skip deleting content is true. Then a move content operation starts, and meanwhile, the content will not be deleted from the source storage area, which is different with before. Then the third part, how to config skip deleting content from this source storage area. This need to add parameter content.move.skipDelete underscore storage area ID equals true here. Storage area ID is the source storage area ID. Then how to config? We have two choices. The first choice is to add parameter into generic GVM parameter. We can refer to the following link. And the second choice is to add parameter into FileNet.property file. You can refer to the second text note to add parameter. Then the last part is the demo for the test steps for the parameters, these new functions from FileNet 559. First, we need to create two advanced storage areas. Each ASA should have three file system devices, and each ASA has its own storage policy. For example, storage policy for ASA02 is ASA02 underscore storage underscore policy. We need to record the ASA ID for the source storage area, ASA01. It is recorded here. Then we need to upload test document. Here we can see that we uploaded two test documents. The first one is test01, and the storage area is ASA01. Storage policy is ASA01 underscore storage underscore policy. From the uploading piece, we can see that the file test01 is saved in the three file system devices. We checked the physical directory. The saved files are all there, and only file system devices name are different. FS01, FS02, and FS03. Then we add a parameter into GVM parameter. Skip.delete underscore storage.areaID equals true. The original generic GVM arguments is here. Then we add a new line, uppercase D, content.move.skipDelete underscore with the source storage area ID equals true. Then we need to restart WAS app after that. Then we create a bulk move job. It is named move to ASA02. The document title is test01, which is the first test document we uploaded just now. Storage policy is ASA02 underscore storage underscore policy, which is the target storage area. After that, we run the bulk move job. After the job finished, we can see that the test01 file has been changed to the storage area to ASA02. Then the storage policy is changed to ASA02 underscore storage underscore policy. But the files still exist in the 3-4 system of ASA01. That means from FileNet perspective, the file has been moved from ASA01 to ASA02 already, and has nothing to do with ASA01. In most of the scenario, this function will be used in a large migration project, and the customer will retrieve the old storage devices in original ASA01 and destroy everything. If you have any further question, please help to contact IBM FileNet support. Thank you.